There is an artist who decided that he wasn't quite doing enough with the natural media that he was working with, so he wanted to make a ring that actually uses his very own skin. The man went under the knife to get a little strip of skin taken out of his stomach, off the top of, I know, it just gives me the willies just thinking about it. And then he put it on top of a 24-karat gold ring, hair and all.
Oh,
it
God.
Was tanned, complete with its hair intact, mounted on the ring, and talk about one ring to rule them all. If you really want to buy this ring, it'll cost you $470,000 for this human skin ring. Okay, so who's buying?
With $470,000? I don't think I'm going to be buying anytime soon. First, can you bring that back up really fast? My favorite thing about this, so you made the Lord of the Rings joke.
Yes.
That literally looks like Gollum's scalp around the one ring. That is some awesome Lord of the Rings synergy right there.
Hey, but you know, sorry, go ahead.
No.
If you really want to have it, you can actually get a DNA certificate and a DVD documentary of the whole process. I mean, come on, who wouldn't want to have a human skin ring?
My question is, why did he pick a part of his body that had such weird hair, right? Like, didn't he have that? It's disgusting. Oh. I mean, it's not very appealing.
And you know, one of the things that this could be it just occurred to me that this could be a whole new side business for Moyles.
Oh,
I know. I had to throw that
in. Yeah, you make the cut, and then on his 21st birthday, you present it to him. Here's another potential tradition. Tell me that maybe this is me being overly either morbid or romantic, but you know, we talk about marriage till death do us part. We have these gold rings. Uh-uh. Why not have some skin from your spouse?
Because it's disgusting.
Who needs tattoos? Who needs his and her tattoos?
Exactly.
Your mom, a posted.
No,
but
wonder,
shave it. Don't have
do
the
you
hair.
Think this will become a trend? I mean, I wonder, we have leather bags.
I hope not.
No, I don't.
We have leather bags. We have leather shoes. We have leather jackets from cows. And I mean, they're not consenting. At least here you have a man who's consenting to the surgical procedure, right? Uh-huh. He decides to maybe cuts six inch by six inches and make a wallet out of it. Maybe somebody else will buy it. Like, is this gonna become a trend? Who knows, right? Especially if it's not a hairy part. The hairy parts are just kind of weird.
Well, you know, probably girls' skin would be better and prettier anyway. But you know, the Nazis already gone through this particular aspect decoration.
What, 475,000, something like that? Did you say
470? Yeah.
So. What's the particular thing about this guy? Like, he's an artist.
A
piece of my skin. Yeah. Is he a famous artist or something?
You know, famous.
Why him?
Don't know.
Why
I've
do we care?
I've never heard of him. He's in Iceland, so you know, maybe he's famous to them. And but you know, that's something where there are times when artists go out there on a limb and they bring up discussion about what is appropriate for art, what is art, would you consider this art, or just a great way to get some attention.
Definitely, it's both. But a couple points. So to your point, like who wants this guy's skin? Like, give me like a little strip of Olivia Wilde around a ring or something like that. I'll pay $500,000 for that.
God.
No, that's weird because I don't want to think about her running around with a big splotch out of her abdomen.
Yeah.
But also, I think we're missing one point. And now there's no confirmation here that he was actually able to sell this yet, although he probably will be able to eventually. So he's got this gold ring. Normally, you'd put diamonds, rubies, or something like that. Not necessarily $500,000 worth, but a couple hundred thousand. All he put was a little bit of skin. If he can actually sell this, is the best business idea he's ever had. He's making amazing money for his investment.